One of the things that you can't do is have it both ways. You can't come to the floor of the House one day and accuse the Republicans of not spending enough, which was exactly what happened here during the Medicare debate, which is exactly what happened here during the budget debate, and then later say, we're spending too much. Which one is it? Do you believe that we're spending too little, or do you believe we're spending too much? I happen to believe that if anything, we're spending too much. I happen to believe that if anything, we're spending too much. But I think what you cannot do is have it both ways, and that's what I've kept hearing the gentleman yield. Again, what I'm saying, though, is you can't have it both ways. Because what I've heard, and I know I'm relatively new here, what I've heard consistently in the budget committee was Republicans are not spending enough. And every single proposal, by the way, including the Blue Draw proposal, spent more money. And yet, my dear friend, Congressman Boyd, who I respect immensely and who I, you know, have a friendship with, now says that we're spending too much. Which one is it? Which one is it?
That is the basis of the Blue Dog philosophy and theory.
If the gentleman will yield,
we ought to balance the budget and pay down the debt.
If the gentleman will yield for a second. But yet, when we were here on the floor, it's very nice to say those things, but when we were here on the floor, we had votes. We had votes on the budget. And the votes on the budget were a partisan vote. And I may be wrong, but I think the Blue Dogs voted against the Republican budget, and the argument there was that we weren't spending enough money. And if you look at the Blue Dog budget, the Blue Dog budget in 2006 to 2011 raises taxes by $124 billion. And by the way, it would not make the tax cuts permanent. And there is the vote. So it's very nice, you know, we can say anything and it kind of gets diffused in the air. But the facts are the facts. And I'm glad you said that, sir. Let's talk about the facts. The votes were there. We had two budgets. A much larger budget, which is a Democratic budget, a smaller budget, a tighter budget, a more responsible budget. And you all didn't vote for that. Those are the facts. You know, a couple things. We heard about are there some things that we could work together? And I agree with you. You can't have it both ways. You can't have it both ways. I mean, you can't on one side of your mouth say that we're not spending enough and the other side of your mouth, when there are no votes, then there are no votes on the table, say that we're spending too much, is what we keep hearing from our colleagues on the Democratic side. You'll recall, I want to see if a couple things that, let's see if you would agree with me. You recall that the chairman of the budget committee wanted to do a 1% cut in waste, fraud, and abuse.
That's correct.
Do you recall if we got any Democratic support for that?
To the best of my knowledge, I don't recall any.
And so there are a few things that, you know, again, facts, we got to talk about the facts. Let's talk about the facts. When our dear friends, when our dear friends on the Democratic side just said a little while ago, kind of equating tax cuts with government spending, I think that really boils down what the differences are. There's a huge difference between more government spending and tax cuts. More government spending are Washington bureaucrats spending the taxpayers' money. Tax cuts is allowing taxpayers of this country, hardworking men and women of our country, and small businesses to keep more of their money. We have a huge philosophical difference when you equate tax cuts with more government spending. Thank you, Mr. Kington. I agree that we should look at positive ways to agree. I'd like to give 10 seconds, if I could, to yield 10 seconds to anybody there who would answer. Would you all agree to that 1% cut that we tried to do? Would you vote for it?
Yeah, I think you'll find agreement over here.
But you didn't vote for it. You didn't support it. And the committee
Support the Blue Dog budget either.
No.
That would have resulted in $421 billion, Speaker,
if I may reclaim my time, you can take all of yours. I didn't support the Blue Dog budget because it increased taxes. And those are the facts. I didn't support the Blue Dog taxes because it raised taxes on the hard-working American people to fund more bureaucracy, more bureaucrats, while ours cut taxes. I didn't support the Blue Dog taxes because it didn't make the tax cuts permanent. You better believe I didn't support it. And I'm asking a specific question, which I cannot get a specific answer because we keep hearing two different sides of the solution. None of the Democrats supported the 1% cut on waste, fraud, and abuse. Those are the facts. That's the reality. This is the party that has got a balanced budget that cuts taxes on the working people, that does not raise taxes. And unfortunately, the blue dog budget did. And that, when you strip that budget down, it's not a blue dog budget, it's just a dog budget. It's a sad dog budget because it increases taxes on the working people to fund more bureaucracy. And I think, again, if we want to work together, support, for example, that 1% tax cut on fraud and abuse that none of you did in committee. Those are the facts. Thank you, sir.